far, we have coloured in our peel-off designs. This time we're going to colour onto our peel-off designs to change the colour of them. Of course, we can get peel-offs in gold, in silver, in pink, in lilac, in many different colours, but this time we're going to make them multicoloured. So I've got a beautiful peel-off sheet here, the leaves design. I'm taking the peel-off pens, which are the permanent marker pens, and I'm taking three different colours. I've got my yellow, the green and the brown. And this time, I'm just going to colour over the top of a peel-off design. So you can just scribble, doesn't have to be perfect by any means. We can put flashes of colour wherever we want to have them. Put a little bit more down here. I'm going to colour some of the little shapes around the side because I'm going to use those too. So I have a selection of those. We'll go back over now with the yellow and then the green. Now while this is drying, I'm going to create a background effect. So I've got a piece of card and that's wide enough for me to do. Now these are some special pens. They're the watercolouring system from Artcure. They already have a watercolour in the pen itself. It's the same manufacturer of the water brush and they have the watercolour paint in here already, so it's ready for me to use directly onto my cardstock. So I'm going to create, you can see here, this sort of colour wash effect. So I'm just going to wash this across my card. Now you just squeeze, if I squeeze a little bit more, more of the paint will come out for me. So this is just giving me a nice effect. And then I'm going to bring the yellow here into the centre. You can see this picking up some of the other colour as well. I'm blending this into there too. And then I'm going to take the water brush and go over the top and colour wash this down. You can see those colours blending together. Now my colour wash background has dried off, I'm going to take the Encore Ultimate Metallic ink pad and some kitchen roll and just scrunch this up. I'm going to apply some gold colour onto here just to give us our own decorative background. So literally just dab onto the ink pad and dab directly onto our background, which is going to give it a nice gilt effect. And my peel off is now dry as well. We can take this design off here and apply it directly onto the background that we've just created. And just position that centrally. And tap that down. Again, you should really wait for your metallic ink just to dry a little bit, but I'm very impatient. I want to get this done quickly. And now use a paper trimmer to cut out around there. Now a little tip for you when using paper trimmers as well. And this is, people ask me, how do I get the proper rectangles and squares? Now with the Fiskars paper trimmer, you have a little lip here. You also have measurements running both ways. Now if you take your piece of card and put it right against that lip so it's straight, and it has to be, of course, a straight card edge to help guide you. But then you just cut and you've got that perfect edge. Again, just line this up here, holding my card in place, run that along. Now I'm going to cut a section of this really chunky decorative card. Now this is a bit more difficult to cut through the paper trimmer. So I'm going to cut this one by hand. I'm going to position it approximately where I want it to go and see how much border I want around the edge and that it's the same around each side. Now this is quite textured and quite bumpy, so it doesn't matter if it's not a perfect cut edge. I think that adds to the character of it. And then I want to have a gold mirror mat around the edge of that. So this time I'm just going to lay it on here and think, yep, I want that amount around both sides. Make a little nick with my scissors there and then cut this down. And then I've got a leather effect larger piece of card, an A4 card, and I'm putting this down to make my greeting card. I And then I have my little mats ready to work with. Use my good old sticky dots. When we're working with heavier cardstock, then you do need more sticky dots on to hold it in place, or you can choose to use a double-sided tape, which will be a little bit heavier. For something like this, I think the double-sided tape is probably the best way to go. Now, this is an easy lift tape. There's nothing more annoying with double-sided tape when you get it down onto the back of your paper or card and you can't take the release paper off there. Now, always to take the release paper off, use your piercing tool, which is hiding over here. But this is easy because you can see here, this particular double-sided tape, the backing paper, the release tape, is wider than the little adhesive strip itself. So when you're pulling this off, it's so much easier to work with. I'm going to turn this around now and pop that down onto the mirror card. And then again, I'm going to use the easy lift tape on here just to give us a little bit more strength and consistency because we're sticking it onto that uneven finish. So just run that along. Now I've got that onto my card and I want to just put these additional motifs that I coloured in just to use around the edge of my design to give it a little bit more detail. There we go. And we're finished. Very simple, but again, we've created that beautiful colour effect on our peel-off stickers and created our own colour wash background. These are some that we did earlier, just to give you an idea of how varied they can look.